Hello and welcome to this cooking company class. Today I'll be showing you how to cook double chocolate chip cookies. First, you're going to preheat the oven to 360 degrees Fahrenheit. That's gas mark 4. You need to put a saucepan on the simmer, just boiling, it boils. Okay, that'll be so you can cook up chocolate. For 8 people, you need to get 4 egg yolks or 4 egg whites. Se você passa, eu me desmancho em dor. Se você fica, eu quero dar o meu amor. Dentro de toda história, assim começo, meio e fim. Then we have 360 grams of dark chocolate there. We have 600 grams of flour, of self-raising flour, 3 tablespoons of baking powder, 1 tablespoon of salt, 4 eggs, 330 grams of butter, 160 millimeters of milk, and 300 grams of brown sugar. We also have over here 2 baking trays, layered with parchment paper. We also have, as provisions, a spatula, a spoon, a wooden spoon, spare parchment paper, sieve and a bowl. You may not need the sieve. Also, it would help if you have some weighing scales.
Do now is cook the chocolate.
So once it's on the boil, like this one has, you lift up the lid and you put this in like that. Wait for it to melt. It should melt very quickly. It's more melted, it's probably more efficient. And just melt it, you can see it's melting right now. Very nice.
Stir it
and just cook it up the process. Okay. So in a circular motion, that's why it's nice to do it. No trick needed, it's comfort there, just crush it. So now we'll add all of our ingredients. Flour, baking powder, salt, butter, brown sugar. Four eggs, two, four, and a milk. Okay, and now we're just going to stir the mixture so it gets into a nice doughy mixture. Okay, fold it in. See, it's come to that nice dark chocolatey flavour now. When it gets to a doughy form, then we'll start actually making the cookies and adding our toppings or chocolate buttons inside, whichever you prefer. Mixes it all nice and good. See that lovely chocolate doughy flavour. Please, until you do it on the second packet. Nice and crushed. Simply add it again. When you finish, just put it in the bin. Well, we've also got some of these sprinkles. So we've got little chocolate grains. We've got these ones, almost run out, but we can still just use them. Little chocolate cylinder things, very nice. And there's a milk chocolate drop.
Just keep it there, keep it there, keep it there. Yeah.
Go ahead by these ones. Doesn't matter how much you add, just not a large amount.
should add some other flower into it.
Like a flower bending in the breeze, bending with me, swear with me.
Okay. When we dance, gently stirring.
Stay with me.
Like so. Swear with me. Get it nice
and thick
and
heavy.
It's cool. Just use this spoon. Get a nice helping. Just fill up the entire baking tray. Doesn't matter if you spill it anywhere, that's fine. If they touch, you can just chop them off from each other. It's fine. Okay. Once done, maybe we should get your oven mitts. We've got nice Chatsworth ones. Okay. Can you open the oven? Try and stand back so the heat doesn't hit you straight away. Place inside. Close. Wait for 12 minutes and then we're done. I'm just going to give you a shot of the oven. At the moment they look cooked, but they're actually not. They're very, very soft. I've just put a new tray in now. Just going to let them simmer in there for a wee while longer, because it hasn't been that long. Let's see what the outcome is. They still look very good though. Okay, so we had loads of baking mix left over from this bowl. What we've done is emptied out into this nice little tray here, like a little brownie type thing where you can just like chop it up and get some a nice bit. What we can do is just open the oven. Okay. Just put them in the bottom. Like so. Okay.
Shouldn't you be saving that?
No.
Nice.
Right, it's been 12 minutes, we're just going to check on them, okay? Get out. Put them on the side, don't put them on the work surface, because you don't want to burn it. Get out. They're not round shaped, but then they are slightly burnt, but they're perfect. I mean, all you got to do. Yeah. Look at that cookie!
It's look quite nice actually.
Right, now they're cooked, the Oreos, the giant Oreos which we're making. All you do is get them off. Come off quite easy, you just use a spatula. Go, peel off, bam. What we'll do, use the bottom part. Get a nice squirt whipped cream, give a nice little shake. Do whatever pattern you want. What was best is to get a nice little spoon or something and just mix it in. Make it nice. I'll do it a bit more creamed, might not done. I know that'll be enough. Now you've listened to my story. Eat second one. Put it on top. Giant Oreo. Very nice. Bye. Oh my god. I'm just about to get the brownie we made out. Not a brownie, just the rest of the chocolate. Okay. That looks gorgeous.
Wait.
The Autastic Oreo. These are others which are the mismatched ones, but they're still very nice.
Well, it's a marvelous this isn't just any food, this is Nick's food.
Dance with this isn't just normal food, this is M&S food. A fantabulous night to make romance beneath the cover of October skies. And all the leaves on the trees are...